Jay Barnett's personal purpose is to empower young people to think big and dream big. His new book is called Finding Our Lost Kings and Queens, and he's here with us in studio. Strategies for Empowering Our Future Kings and Queens. Welcome.
All right. How you doing, Sam?
I'm doing great. Now, you're a young guy from down south, the Delta.
Yes,
right?
Sir.
So tell me your journey. I heard you had a cup of coffee with the NFL, and then you decided to help kids. So walk us through how you got from being who you are to right being an author.
Yes, Stan, I have a very, very powerful journey, story that I was born and raised in Mississippi. Parents divorced when I was 13 years old, and after the divorce, I'm telling you, Stan, I just lost my sense of direction. Having a father that I looked up to and that I kind of wanted to be like and pattern myself after my parents' divorce, I just didn't have anything else to identify myself with. Mm-hmm. So football became everything to me. My mother moved us to Texas, and after being in Texas, I turned out to be a very good athlete and received a scholarship to Tarleton State University. After being there 4 years, and playing, had a great collegiate career. I had the opportunity to go to the Green Bay Packers and didn't work out. Played a couple of years of arena football. And so what happened, Stan, is just letting football just be my guide for everything. After that was gone, I really didn't have anything else to identify with. So I found myself into a deep depression. Led to two suicide attempts, and I'm just blessed to be here to be alive today. What I noticed is that...
Well, let me back up, because that's pretty powerful. So the suicide attempts, what led you? Young man, good athlete, all of a sudden sports is over. What was it that caused you to think about suicide? Was it that you had all your chips in one basket with the NFL?
Exactly. I had all my chips in one basket, and as most of us athletes, I mean, we love sports so dearly because it's such a universal language, and it does so much for us, especially for, you know, I had a kid that had so much anger and so much aggression, so football was very dear to me, and I just felt invaluable. I felt insignificant. I felt like I wasn't a nobody. I felt like I was a failure, and all of this after I graduated college. Mm. So because I didn't know anything else, and football became basically, you know, my support system. And once that support system failed, that's when I found myself in a deep depression, because I didn't really know what else I could do in life. And
what changed you? What made you change?
What changed me, Stan, is just realizing that I had a sense of purpose, surviving those suicide attempts, and realizing that, I mean, there was a reason why I woke up after taking an overdose, and understanding that, you know what, maybe God has a purpose and a plan for me to be here and to reach out to other young men that may be struggling with this issue, and other young ladies that may be struggling with, you know, identifying with something beyond what they have. And so That really turned my life around and inspired me to write this book, because I didn't understand what a king was. My mother had always called me a king, and I just didn't understand, you know, the dynamics of being a king and taking ownership for my kingdom, which is my own individual, you know, personal self.
And I'm assuming the king and queens comes from the fact that the motherland is Africa, where kings and queens sort of start. So if everyone comes from Africa, then kings and queens are where your roots are, right?
Right.
So when you talk to young kids, I think the issue of sports being the end-all, be-all for a lot of urban kids, and even suicide, the rate of suicide among young people and young males in particular, young black males, has increased.
Yes.
I imagine there's some traction when you talk to young people about suicide, about having all your eggs in sports, that that's something that a lot of kids need to hear, but don't always have someone who they can talk to about that.
Right, exactly, and especially to have somebody that they can relate to. I'm so grateful to, you know, be able to relate to them with my message, and to be relevant, to be able to go to, you know, the homes, the centers, the youth centers, and the schools, and to be able to carry a message that they can understand and thread it with some of the hip hop and some of the things that they relate to, tie in some of the music icons that they look up to, also to help them understand that you can be more than an athlete.
Right. Because how do we change that? I mean, to cut you off, because you're saying it's very important. How do you change that dynamic? Because you know that I do, in urban communities, that dynamic is there too often, where the students don't see the relevance in education, but they feel there's equity in the music industry and sports. They feel they're judged equally, but they don't find the same value in the in the books, and yet we know to make it as a rap star or an athlete is literally one in a million, and that's probably being very generous. So how do you flip the script where they begin to come see value in education?
Well, you can only place value based upon the perspective that is being displayed. So we have to change their perspective based on their perception, what they are seeing, because kids emulate what they see. Mm. If all they see is negativity, we can't expect anything else from them. And so that is, which is why I use the King and Queen acronym to help them understand that, hey, you're a king, you're a queen. You don't have to be hood, you don't have to be, you know, ghetto, you don't have to act, you know, these things that you hear negative. So, and if we present to them positive reinforcement, and if we take, you know, the initiative to put them before things that, you know, goes beyond, because social media put everything before them, you know, for the rap stars and the entertainers.
Right.
I grew up in Mississippi, so I grew up with a lot of civil rights activists around, the great Megan Evers from Jackson, Mississippi. So I grew up learning about these different people that we can be like. So for them, you know, they don't see authors. And all they see is, you know, sports icons, the Lil Waynes. And so I'm blessed to be able to let them see an athlete turn author to where they can see that it's cool to be educated.
Right, to learn. So the self-image issue, because I think that is huge. If you're gonna turn around education in any community, self-image is where it starts. But sometimes when kids affirm a positive image, it's not always embraced by their peers. They got to make sure who they're surrounding themselves around, because sometimes you affirm yourself in a different image, but the people you're hanging out with don't affirm it, and then kids end up having that peer pressure, and they'll go down to the level of where
right.
they are.
And which is an important stand for parents to be active, man. It's so important for parents to be involved in the children's life, to affirm them and validate them, because I was a kid, when my parents divorced, I was an AB student, and when they divorced, I quickly turned to a student that didn't care. I was very disrupted in class. I failed the eighth grade. Mm. I was seeking for attention, because being smart is not cool. So
we have about 2 minutes. What was reaffirming for you after the suicide attempts, and then you had a spiritual conversion, you had God came into your life. What do you think were the things, what did you reaffirm yourself as after football was over? What did you now see yourself as?
Now I saw myself as a king. Understanding who I am, that my kingdom can only be controlled and be ran by me. And once you know that you're a king, you can never be a servant to music, any negative influence. And I realized that I had to take control of my life and of my situation.
Did that come through counseling, through prayer, through Bible study? Where did you now begin to change, flip the script on your thinking?
My thinking came through a lot of prayer, a lot of counseling, and which is a lot of us as African Americans sometimes oppose. You know, we just don't want to get people in our
sure.
business. But I had to go and change my mindset. Had to change the way I thought, because you're thoughts governs your actions. Mm. And so once I changed my mind to realize that life will be what you make it.
You change the whole course of your life.
Change the whole All course right. of your life.
His name is Jay Barnett, folks. The book is Finding Our Lost Kings and Queens. Thank you, Jay, for your time. We appreciate
you,
it. We come back, folks. We'll talk about a young man who had a fall from grace, a former UConn basketball star. Tate George led the Huskies to their dream season in 1990. He's in big trouble in a